Hello and welcome to Position 6. My name is Dan Offen, aka Mr. Big James. And what is this? A crossover episode. It's me and the Sidepool guys, Lee Fitor and Capsulist. I'm big fans of both of them as people, as well as talents and broadcasters. I like their podcast a lot. This is the second half of an episode I recorded of them just after the summit when I was still in LA. The first half is on the Sidepool channel, their YouTube or their various podcasting streams, so you can go and check that out there. I've also linked it in the episode description. But this half follows on directly from the first half, so listen to it first.
Yeah, a lot of the Europeans, for example, Lufthansa just cancelled all their flights. Wepa's flight got cancelled. He had to get a different flight that goes through London.
EasyJet fucked.
Yeah. No, I mean, they've got new flights, they're fine.
Part of the reason why the major kind of, you know, hurt is because people are still in Europe too, right? So yeah, they're like, how do we get here? Guess we can't. What are we going to do?
It's the production staff more, because a lot of the teams were already here.
One of the reasons why I'm most selfishly bummed about the whole LA major situation is that I was so excited to have people coming out here who I can be like, hey, y'all, let's go get tacos.
Yeah.
Like, it's not often that you have a bunch of friends come to your city. And even though a lot of them don't have a lot of spare time, it's very like, hey, I have a car. Hey, yeah, yeah. I know what's here. Did you find out like early, Cap? Like, did someone be like, did someone be out calling and be like, hey, by the way, or did you kind of find out with everyone else?
In fact, Slasher released, said that players and casters have gotten official word. I had not gotten official word.
Yeah, we all found out at the same time.
Yeah, that was the thing about that is I got like a slight heads up a couple hours, rumors, leaks, that sort of thing. Probably the same way Slasher picked it up, but him saying like the official word had gone to players and casters, then I was sitting there going like,
nope.
Yeah, it's like 6 a.m. in Europe right now. Like, our contact is definitely asleep. Like,
I can't believe, you know, aside from the fact that, you know, it is kind of a bummer from like a Dota standpoint, there's so many like unanswered questions about what happens with the DPC circuit. Does this event ever happen? What happens to points? Do people get points? Do we cancel an event? Is TI going to happen because of this thing? Like, there's so many questions, right?
Uh-huh.
All I'm caught up on is I can't stop thinking about how much money ESL has to have lost in the last month.
Between
this and Katowice and everything with the CSGO Pro League, like I can't, the CSGO event in Brazil almost certainly isn't going to happen. I can't even begin to, like, what do you do from a business standpoint? Like, it's not like you have insurance, right? Like, how do they keep surviving?
As a good example, in the Smash scene, there's CEO, right?
Yes.
And they actually put out a GoFundMe because their margins are at a point. Like, ESL is a huge ass company and they've got investment capital, so but they can afford to be in the red, you know. Meanwhile, it's like those tournament organizers, they don't have any of that, so their margins are much, much smaller. And they, you know, one event going bad like that, you have to set up a GoFundMe just to like try and pay some people out, try and recover some of those losses. Like, no company like self-respecting is gonna be like,
yeah,
great, let's do a GoFundMe. That goes to show the depths of which you sunk to be like.
Mm-hmm.